divide that up in several ways if you want. Let's just go ahead and start. Sometimes he makes me lie down. Because he knows if he don't make me, I'm not going. I'm busy, thank you. I got things to do, places to go, people to see. I don't have time for any pause. And yet, Scripture gives us great direction that we need pauses in our life. We need, every once in a while, to rest. And there are times, and I don't have the full theology of this, the full understanding of this, but I believe it's consistent in Scripture, that there are times he makes some of us lie down and stop. And in those times, even as the Scripture says later, he restores our soul. In those times, he feeds us. In those times, he speaks to us. In those times, he shows himself to us. Is it always my choice? No, because it says he makes. I don't think. Green pastures simply means to me that in that place that I lie down, I have everything I need. Everything that he is there, he has provided for me, everything I need is there. It's not because he's not with us. I think probably some of you have felt what I have felt at times. There were some times, especially back in the mid-90s, that I went through a very, very, very difficult time in my life. There were times I couldn't even go to church. I'd stay at the house, and I'd spend all day pacing the whole house. And one of the things I would pray is, Lord, why have you left me? Lord, why have you left me? He hadn't. But I felt like he had. In those times that he stops us, don't ever believe the lie of Satan that the Lord has turned away from you. Don't ever believe that he's forsaken you. He cannot, because he can't go against his word. As I've done probably ad nauseum, I just remind you again, in all of us, there is a difference between what we know and what we feel. There are times we feel forsaken, but we are not forsaken. There are times we feel like we have no future, but as long as we have the Lord directing our life, we have his hope and his future in our life. But we ought to always feel like it. Just mention this. I believe with all of my heart that Jesus spent a moment with a conflict between what he knew and what he felt. Jesus, hanging on the cross, said this, Father, why have you forsaken me? And yet, just hours before, he had explained to his disciples, this had to happen. He knew it had to happen. He was convinced it had to happen. But his feelings said in the garden, Lord, is there any way we can do this any other way? But yet in his knowing, he went to the cross. In his knowing, he paid the penalty for our sin. But you see, in that price that he paid, he made himself susceptible to feelings by coming in human flesh. And I believe that he understands when we struggle between what we know and what we feel. One more time. He leads me beside still waters. Of course, the first thought is the refreshing, the purity, the clean, the life that is in water. But the one thing that I have felt so clearly in this is that the reason it's still waters is because when you lean down over still waters, what do you see? Yourself. I believe in those times of refreshing, in those times that the Lord is dealing with our life, He will let the Holy Spirit Himself reveal ourselves to ourselves. Since I was a little boy, I remember one of the songs we sang in church a lot was, "Search me, O God, and know my heart today. Try me, O Savior, and know my thoughts, I pray. See if there be any wicked way in me. Cleanse me from every sin and set me free." There are times I believe that He wants us to do an audit. He wants us to see what is important in our life. And He stops us long enough to show us our sins. And in all that time, and this will be one of the things we will major on the next time we get to this, and it won't be next Sunday, but it will be soon. And that is that He is always with us in all this process.
Would you turn with us to page 688? Savior, like a shepherd, lead us. Let you lead in a tender care. Page 688, if you'd like to follow along. ask him to forgive me, cleanse my sins, and to be my shepherd that leads and that cares for me. I'd like to ask if you would just to slip your hand up quickly and back down. We just want to pray with you. We want to agree with you in prayer that he will comfort you and that he will lead you. Father God, love us. You care for us. And that you will provide for us. So Lord, as we've sung about today, as we've talked about today, Lord, when we need a shelter, let us run to you. When we need a healer, help us to run to you. When we need someone just to hold us, help us just to call your name. Be our shepherd today.
Thank you.